G'day guys, this is a video update for one of the ROM hacks I've been working on. I believe it was Lemmings color palette fix. Well, I've got a bit of an update for you as of the 25th of March 2024. And just to give you guys a bit of a heads up on this, is that now this palette fix hack is almost in completion and all that. Well, actually it is completed and all that. I'm actually going to be releasing this over at romhacking.net. So by the time you watch this video, guys, the link will be in the description below for you guys to be able to try this hack out if you want to give it a go. If you got any questions or you got questions about this ROM hack or anything like that, or you want permission for something, yeah, feel free to let me know here on the comments below and all that. With that being said, without further ado, let me just show you what I've been working on here. Now you got your usual Sega logo, which is actually normal. Now right here, I've actually tinkered with the palettes and all that, and actually make it similar to the Commodore Amiga's intro of the game, which is why it's a bit brighter and a bit more lighter rather than darker. And you can definitely see that there's been a lot of improvements on this, like the dirt ground in the background has been lightened up, the grass is actually lightened up too, and the actual lemmings are actually better to see now. As soon as this sequence is over, I'll show you what else I've been working on and all that. There we go. As you can see right here, the lemmings, the actual lemmings, game title. I've actually done a bit of work on the palettes on this as well, like with the logo and everything like that, to enhance the colours and all that. The brown dirt background has actually got a bit more volume into it now, and also that film roller that actually shows the right and all that too, just made the palette absolutely good and a bit more better to see, just similar to the Corbin Omega version and all that. As well as the writing being a bit richer and all that to be able to see properly. And with that being said, let me just put in the code here so that way I can show you all the levels. Yeah, so in the first level, as you can see, the level and all that hasn't been touched. But I'll tell you what has been worked on, and it's all the release rate, the skills, the pause button, the nuke and the map. As you can see, this has actually all been rectified and all that, and I've gotten around to changing the palettes on the color palette on that just to make it kind of similar to the Commodore Amigas in some degree. And it's the same with the in and out and the percentage and the time color palettes as well. That way it actually looks a bit richer and a bit more balanced and contrasted a little bit. And of course, what I've actually done too, I've actually fixed the color palettes on the lemmings when you play the game and all that, because their blue outfits were a bit darker compared to the Commodore Amigas, the PCs, the Super Nintendos, and vice versa. Yeah, but everything else has been unchanged for the time being. Like the pillar layout, it's still the same as it was in the previous, because I actually really like how this turned out. So there's absolutely no change needed to be done on this one so far. Alrighty, let me skip this level. The marble layout has not been touched, only because it actually looks better and all right as it is. So there is absolutely really no needed to change this one in particular. Yeah, so it's already as good as it is. And not to mention one of the best soundtracks of this game too as well. Yeah, the crystal level, it still hasn't been touched since the last update, only because this one's actually pretty good as it is. So I reckon there's really no need to actually go ahead and change this at all whatsoever, since it actually looks good as it is. It makes it a lot easier, you know, to be able to play this when playing on the emulator, like Kiga Fusion, Gen and all that. Or in my case, what I'm doing here, playing this on real hardware on the Sega Mega Drive 2 console with the Mega Everdrive X7, which is what I'm using. And and the video format on this is actually absolutely schmick and absolutely superior. HD Richer Vision's YPBBR component cables, and also using the Elgato HD 60S to actually game capture this in full 50 frames a second in PAL. But and that's the thing too. This is actually a ROM hack used from the PAL version of Lemmings for the Sega Mega Drive. And all right, there's one more I need to show you, and it's the fire level, the fire layout. As you can see, it no longer has that that greyish yellow look like the Super Nintendo has. So I've actually went ahead and went back to this to make it similar to the Commodore Amiga's version in some degree. But due to the Sega Mega Drive's pellet limitations and all that, it only outputs 9-bit or something like that, which I can't remember how many it is. I'm guessing about 256 colors or something like that. Correct me if I'm wrong. But it's not fully 16-bit like the actual Super Nintendo console or something like that. Because if it had a lot of pellets like the Super Nintendo, I reckon I could have done more better and all that. Absolutely. And so far already, it actually started to look really good so far and all that. But yeah, that's all the changes I've actually done with this game so far. Is the task of the release rate, the map, the nuke, and the pause button down here. The pellets have been changed and all that, as well as the adjustment of the contrast on the other info as well. Well, with that being said, guys, that's all I wanted to showcase for you. So thank you very much for watching this short video and all that. I hope you actually like what you like here. And like I said earlier on, if you've got any questions that you want to bring up, will I do more work for a future release or something like that, or you want permission in regards about this ROM, you're more than welcome to contact me if you want to ask permission for anything in particular in regards to this ROM hack. Yep. Don't hesitate, let me know, and I'll definitely give you an answer as much as I possibly can. Alright guys, with that being said, thanks very much for watching, thanks for liking, and if you're actually new, be sure to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell icon if you want to be notified of new gaming videos. Thanks very much for watching, guys. Take it easy, stay safe, and most of all, game on.